And talk about down to the wire, the New England Patriots' last-second field goal gave them a 32-29 victory over the Carolina Panthers in Super Bowl 38. It's New England's second Super Bowl title in the past 3 years, both won by field goals. Enough about the game. What about the ads? Many people watch the Super Bowl just for the commercials. The little donkey that could won over most of the country. Budweiser's Donkey Dream was voted America's favorite ad last night. This according to ADBOWL, the real-time interactive advertising ranking system. ADBOWL is developed by McKee, Walwerk, Henderson, and Steve McKee is the president. We're pleased to have you here.
Pleased to be here. Thank you.
Tell me quickly how this all works.
Well, it's very simple. ADBOWL is a real-time interactive voting system, so as the ads aired, people could go online and rate them from touchdown to fumble.
Does your research show you that most people are actually voting for these during the game, or do they wait till after and vote?
Most people tend to wait till towards the fourth quarter, but there are those who watch the game on their computer and vote as it goes.
Let's talk about the donkey.
Yes.
A lot of animals in the ads
yesterday. A lot of animals. It's hard to go wrong with animals. The Clydesdales are such an institution, such an American icon, that it's hard not to like them. And so Budweiser's starting with an advantage there, and then they put the Capra-esque twist on it, and just a warm and inviting commercial that nobody could not like.
Yeah. Do you know vote tallies, or do you know how far this was the most popular advertisement?
We grade them on a 5-point scale, and of course that's average. So this probably won by a tenth or two of a point on a 5-point scale. It's always a close competition.
I see in the top five here, three of them are Bud mm-hmm. or some Bud related product, Budweiser, Bud Light. What's your sense? Obviously, beer ads are always a big part of the Super Bowl, no matter what. What's your sense about as you look at the top five here, mm-hmm. themes running through?
Well, the themes, of course, beer, it's a party. The Super Bowl's the world's biggest party, so it's not surprising to see Frito-Lay there or even a car account there. Budweiser has mastered the medium with these slapstick kind of ads. Some would say they go too far, but they sure know how to get people's attention, and they've demonstrated that. They always do well in ADBOWL.
Number two here is Dog Fetch, a Bud Light ad. This was very early in the game that we saw last night. Obviously, another pet ad. What's your sense about whether or not these ads were necessarily worth the vast amounts of money that people were paying for?
Generally speaking, they're definitely worth the money. If you're looking at maybe 2 cents a house, or 2 cents a person, rather, a nickel a household for a consumer product like beer, not to mention, in fact, all the PR that comes off of it and the rerunning of the ad on shows like this, it's certainly a good buy. It can backfire, but I don't think Budweiser is worried about that.
Was the game last night a perfect kind of game for advertisers because it was held right to the last second?
It was, but there is some. We see in ADBOWL year after year, there is some ad fatigue as the game wears on, even if the game is really good. Some ads get repeated. Some ads were not specially created for the Super Bowl, and people start not paying attention quite as much.
Were there any ads that you saw last night in the during the course of the game that you liked that didn't wind up in any of the...
There were a couple. I was very intrigued with the Monster.com ad. I think it might have been a little too cerebral for a Super Bowl party atmosphere, but I'd like to see it again, which is a good test. And I think the best use of the medium goes to Cadillac for the car that outran the sound in the commercial. So it got your attention because you thought maybe something was wrong with your TV, and then mm-hmm. you found out that it wasn't. So I like both of those.
You mentioned that you'd like to see the ad again. Generally, do advertisers keep running these ads? Ads after they air, they debut on the Super Bowl?
Generally they do. It's a big investment, and so they want to milk them. If they're not well received, they won't. Of course, there's the famous Apple 1984 spot that ran only once, and they're very proud of it.
Right. Let's talk about some of the other categories here, because you guys break it down. I was intrigued, and you pointed out to me before we came up here, that the Democrats who were voting, and obviously you have to go through a bit of a poll here before you actually mm-hmm. register your votes, right? What party mm-hmm. you belong to, and mm-hmm. the Democrats like the Donkey Dream ad the best.
Quite naturally.
Is there a political tie in there?
There could be. The frightening thing is independents like it best, too. So if they stay together through the fall, the Republicans have something to be wary of.
What else sort of stuck out as important as you look over these other categories?
Two things that were very important. One is that the women really put the Budweiser Donkey Dream spot over the top, which is a recognition of their increasing role in Super Bowl audience. They're the ones that ranked it the highest and caused it to win. The second thing that was really encouraging to me was that teenagers liked the Office of National Drug Control Policy spot. Really got their attention. And in this day and age of abuse, drug abuse, When there's some debate as to whether or not those commercials work, clearly ADBOWL shows that in this case they paid attention.
I was interested to see those come on, because after that whole hubbub involving CBS regarding the advocacy ads, when the first the anti, and obviously nobody's going to scoff at an anti-drug ad, but what was your sense about having that ad run versus the other ones that CBS rejected?
Well, I think that's the point. There were a number of advocacy ads in this Super Bowl. Not only that, but the anti-tobacco and the designated driver ads. Those are issues that nobody's really going to argue with. And so I think it's very safe territory for CBS.
Who's the demographic? I heard some statistic last night that the median salary of people in the stadium watching the game last night, something enormous, three times what it normally is for a normal NFL game. What's the type of demographic that advertisers are reaching during the Super Bowl advertising?
Traditionally, it's been young men. That's increasingly changing. The Academy Awards is known as kind of the women's Super Bowl, but the Super Bowl attracts 10 million more women than the Academy Awards. And so traditionally it's been young men, but that is changing. With 100 million viewers, you're getting a cross-section of America. So it's just a great broad-based buy for any advertiser.
An interesting poll here. Yes. Steve McKee, thanks for being with us.
Thank you.